Hello everyone, in today's video we'll be talking about hypercementosis. Hypercementosis is a non-neoplastic condition in which excessive cementum is deposited in continuation with the normal radicular cementum. Hypercementosis most commonly involves nearly the entire root area, although in some instances the cementum formation is focal, usually occurring only at the apex of a tooth, or in this case it has occurred from the mid root portion. Talking about etiology, the different etiology of hypercementosis include accelerated elongation of a tooth, inflammation of tooth and tooth repair, and osteotitis deformans or Paget's disease of bone. In cases where the antagonist teeth is missing, the particular tooth that supraerupts, and in the process of supraeruption, the apical portion hypercementosis is induced because the periodontal ligament width tends to remain constant. In an attempt to preserve the width of periodontal ligament, cementum deposition occurs rapidly. That's why accelerated elongation of a tooth results in hypercementosis, and pulpitis, inflammation of, is a result of pulpal infection. It stimulates excessive deposition of cementum, and directly the cementum is not deposited in the apex because in the apical region, due to the inflammation process, the cementoblasts are injured, cementoblasts are lost, and around the radicular portion the cementum deposition takes place. And in the process of tooth repair, although very large amount of cementum is not deposited during tooth repair, but when the teeth supraerupts and when there is root fracture, it is repaired by deposition of cementum between the root fragments. So minor cemental tears, detachment of cementum from the root due to trauma, all these are repaired by cementum, secondary cementum formation. So that also induces hypercementosis. And a disease called osteitis deformans or Paget's disease of bone, it also results in hypercementosis. And clinical features, it does not produce any significant clinical sign or symptoms. Okay, there it is not painful also, there is no sensitivity, there is no tenderness to percussion. So it can be seen as an incidental finding. And when the tooth with hypercementosis is extracted, the root appear larger in diameter than normal and present rounded apexes. Okay, apex of the root should be otherwise pointed, but this has rounded root. This in extreme case we can see bulbous root. On the periapical radiograph, most cases are distinguished by thickening and apparent blunting. Okay, here the dentin and cementum cannot be differentiated. It is impossible to differentiate up to where is dentin, up to where is cementum, but because of the shape we can say this is hypercementosis. Here also it is the same. Histologic feature, microscopic appearance of hypercementosis is characteristic one, in which an excessive amount of secondary or cellular cementum is found deposited directly over the typically thin layer of primary or cellular cementum. Okay, the secondary cementum has been termed osteocementum because it is cellular in nature and its resemblance to bone is also there. It is arranged in concentric layers around the root. And treatment, no treatment is indicated because it does not pose any problem. It is, does not change the prognosis of the tooth. And in cases in which there is hypercementosis due to pulpal infection, if the inflammation due to pulpal lesion is present, then that condition is to be treated. Otherwise, the hypercementosis does not pose any problem. So, extraction of teeth because of hypercementosis is contraindicated, because prognosis of such teeth is excellent if there is no any infection present. That's all about hypercementosis.